Hello everyone. Welcome to the lecture series on ARM microcontroller and embedded systems. This is lecture number 16. So in this lecture we will be studying about the memory systems and memory maps. In the previous lecture we have discussed about the some special instructions and along with that the memory barrier instructions. Okay. So here the memory mapping it is related to how the entire memory is divided and how it has been allocated, like SRAM, DRAM, user space and all. We will see one by one. So here, as you can observe, we have totally the 4 GB space of the memory. So in this 4 GB space, if you observe how the memory has been divided, you can see here. So there is a option here, so you can check out, like, initially the first 500 MB, that is the memory address from 00000002 1FFFFFFF. So this is allocated for the code memory. And similarly, we have the SRAM space, peripheral space, external RAM space and external device space. So external RAM and external device, they are 1 GB, and remaining things you can calculate, and it is mentioned here. So totally we have 4 GB space has been utilized here. And further you can see here this SRAM, how it is again subdivided. So this SRAM has been divided as bit band region and bit alias region, and as well as this external means this peripheral also has been divided as bit band region and bit alias region. And similarly, based on the above thing, so if you observe the another set here, that is private peripheral bus and private peripheral bus for internal and external debug. So that has been again divided as mentioned here. And in particular here in this topic, we will be concentrating on the this memory layout wherein bit band operations are allowed. So bit band operation is nothing but, so if you have like 7 bits or 1 byte, not 7 bits, so if you take a 1 byte value and in that, say, let me adjust this screen over here first. So if you have this totally 8 bits, bit number 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And now if I divide these bit positions based on the data type, so if the data type is of 4 bits, so I may divide these things like this: bit number 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2 and 1. So if the data size or data type is 4 bits, so bit number 1 I can access it like of 4 bits separately. Bit number 4, 3, 2, sorry, bit number 3, 2, 1 and 0 only, not 4. And similarly the 5th bit, it will start at the bit number 2 of the actual memory, and here it will start from bit number 4, next 5, next it will be 6 here, and next it will be 7. So based on this concept, the bit band programming has been designed. So here, depending on the data size, you can decide which bit you want to program. So in simple word, the ARM also allows the programming of the bit wise programming also, not only the byte wise or half word or the word length. You can program individual bits also. So this is possible with respect to the bitband and bitband aliasing region. So we'll see in detail in the coming slides. So next, in order to access the memory, certain attributes have to be followed. So those attributes means the character. If you want to use the memory for different purpose, read and write operation, so you can have the different attributes for that. First one is bufferable, second one is cacheable attribute, third one is executable attribute, fourth one is shareable attribute. So as you can see here, bufferable attribute, it allows to perform a write operation to the memory location. So that is, write to memory can be carried out by a write buffer. So that buffer can be used to perform the write operation, even though the processor may continue to execute the remaining instructions. So if there are four lines in a program, so during the first line is being programmed or being written, remaining three lines may be getting executed one by after the another. So next, similarly, we have a cacheable attribute. So this cacheable attribute, it allows us to obtain a data from a memory, and that can be read through a cache memory. So how it is, that's how it is accessed here. Next is executable attribute. So here the processor can fetch and execute a program code from this memory region. So after you type the program and save it, and once you dump that program into the kit, so while executing that program in the kit, so the processor will read your code from the executable attribute memory location. So next one is shareable. So shareable means data in the memory region can be shared by multiple bus masters. Okay, so that means for example, you can have the copy in the hard disk. So the same thing can be copied onto the pen drive also through the bus itself. So that is the simple example here. So in order to have all these attributes for each memory region, so we have a different range for code memory region. All these attributes may be allowed within this region. And similarly, if you look into the SRAM peripheral region, external RAM region, and external device region, so we have these ranges wherein we have different attributes which are allowed. So depending on that, the either read, write, or execute can be carried out. So next, we have a default memory access permissions. So which all memory locations can be accessed? So it depends on the vendor, first thing. So for example, if we take the ROM table is accessible only within this region. So user cannot use this, it is blocked. So user access, it will not be, means the user cannot access these memory locations. So while performing load and store operations, you may not be able to use this address. So there are some address regions, something like 00000 to 17F. Within this region, you may access for performing load and store operations also. And some memory locations, you can see here, check out here, they are meant for a specific access. So we have this access within this, the user program, or a user can access the memory through the program. Next, we have something like bit band operation. So if I read out this bit band operation, it allows a single load store operation to access a read write to a single data bit. So here I have marked few things. That means single load store operation to access to perform read or write operation to a single data bit. That is, bitwise programming is supported through the bit band operations. So here we have already seen in the memory map. So here we have this bit band region. So basically we have two types of bit band region. One is located in the SRAM, another in the peripheral region. If you are referring to the SRAM, so the bit band region is from 2 followed by 7 zeros to 201 followed by 5 zeros, and their corresponding alias value, what is this alias value, we will see, are located from 22 next followed by 6 zeros to 23 followed by 6F. So within this range these are allowed. So now coming back to the condition here. So if you look into the one example here, so if you want to set bit 2 in world data in the address, this address, then instead of using 3 instruction to read data, set bit and then write back to the result, this can be carried out by a single bit band operation instruction. So how it is done, let us see here. So if you see this memory map totally, okay, so if you refer to this here, this space has been referred from the SRAM where we have the bit band region and bit alias region also. So if you just consider this one, for example, this is the first bit address and or bit band address, which is a 32 bit length value. So 32 bits are divided as 0 to 31 here, and each location, each value here is referred, or we can use the alias address. The alias address will start from 22 6 zeros 2. We have seen the limits there. Okay, so if I consider this particularly, this one and this one, so if I consider these two over here, how they are recognized? So if I go back to this memory mapping, so here we know this is say for example this is 200000, this address, totally 1 MB address. So here if you consider the bit band region, its bit alias region will start from 2 to 6 zeros. So totally it is 22 MB space. So if you consider this one value here, so bit number 2 followed by 70, that contains a 32 bit address. So each bit over there, if you consider now, so how it is read now? So if you want to access bit band region, this one 2 followed by 60, so first bit in that, its address is referred from bit alias. Its address is what now? 2200000. Say now if I want to take the next one, that is 2 followed by 0001, so that indicates the next address here. So how these things are, what these things are actually indicating here now? Bit alias, bit band alias addresses, and how these bit band aliases addresses are referred. So we know Here the data type it is a 32-bit architecture. So 32-bit architecture, it is again referred as one position indicates the four bits. So if I fill here like something like one, one is nothing but in binary it is 0001. So totally it will consume four bits or four addresses. So now if I consider this box here, for example, if I consider this box, this will be having the address from the range 22000002, the address 22000003. So totally how many addresses? 0 1 2 3, totally four locations. So if I consider the next box here, this one, this refers to what now? This address, it will start from 22000004. Next, so totally we have 2 plus 2, okay, so up to which value? To 22000007, next four positions. So bit number 0, bit number 0 of bit band address 2000000 is referred with respect to 22 6 zeros to 22 5 zeros 3. So these are the bit band alias region address, okay. So within this only again we have the four locations. So similarly here, it refers to which one now? If this is 0, this will be this refers to here now. If you assume this refers to this one, refers to the address, which address? 2000000, again 0001. So this is the address here. This will be 2 3 4th bit, like that 31st bit. So similarly, if you take the bit band alias of the peripheral address, so instead of 22, I think we have to refer it as 44. So if you check out that thing here, so we have the locations, bit band regions here, and the bit band alias, they will start from 42. Here it is 22, here it is 42. Okay. So if you refer this, now if you consider the example, now the requirement is we need to read the content of the memory location, this memory location, and we need to set the bit number 2. We need to set the bit number 2 in that. Then we need to write the register content to this location. So this is without bit band operation. If you consider this region is without bit band here to here, and this side is with bit band. So without bit band means you have to load this address first anyway, then you have to load the content of this memory location pointed by the register R0, then we have to perform what? OR operation dot W with respect to R1. R1 is having what now? The content of 20000 means this bit, this one. So this is ORed with 4. Why it is ORed with 4? So we need to set bit 2 in the register, bit 2. So bit 2 in the register, if you consider, so according to that, what will be the value here? What we get? So here it holds totally 4 bits, 0 to 3. Totally the value will be 4. Hence that value is 4 there. Okay. Then if you want to, after performing the OR operation, modifying that. So if you want to store that content back to the memory location, just have to use the STR instruction. So it is taking around 4 instructions here. So the same thing if you want to perform using the bit band operation. So in case of bit band operation, what you have to do? So for bit band operation, this address 2000, 00, and 00 is referred as a bit alias region. So bit alias, bit band alias address starts from 22 followed by these many zeros. So hence you have to load that value R0 here with this value 22 followed by 00008. So here what is the requirement? Write 1 to this value. They have already mentioned this value. So you have to use that. Then move R1 comma hash 1. Then store R1 into R0. So this OR operation is not required here. So this is 8. 8 means which one? This is 0. Okay. So we want to perform the operation 22000008. So write 1 to this value. So this is how it is referred over here. So 220008. So why this address is used? So we want to get the set the bit number 2. So bit number 2, if you refer, it is 0 here, this is 4 here, and this is 8, right? So in order to get that this address, so its bit alias address will be 22000008. So after this 220007, we get this one, right? Bit number 0, bit number 1, and bit number 2. So hence we use this instruction here. Similarly, we can opt for performing the, okay. So if you want to perform a read operation to the same location, 2 followed by 7 zeros, and if you want to shift the bits, bit number 2 to the LSB and mask the other bits, so we know we need to use these instructions. But in case of bit band, instead of specifying this 2 followed by 7 zeros, this is the first bit. First bit. So, and now which bit we want to shift here? Shift the bit number 2. Again, bit number 2 refers to bit band alias address as this one. So instead of bit number 2, if it is bit number 1, we could have used 22000004. Okay, so that means this will be this bit. Okay, this is bit number for 2. Bit number 0, 1, 2. Similarly, if you want to take bit number 3, that will be 22 followed by 00000C. So from that address, it will start. Okay. According to that, you have to consider here. So this table will give you the idea about how the mapping is done internally. Bit 0 is mapped to this bit, alias equivalent value. So as I told, bit number 2 is this value. So bit number 31st, it is 7C. Bit number 31st means, this is bit number 31st. Its address is what? 22 followed by 00000007C. So that is written here. Next, if you take bit number 30, bit number 1 of next address, that will be this address, right? This is 22 000080 as it is mentioned. So this is the thing here, and you can go through the one of the example also here. What is mentioned? You have to set the address to a value, this value, read the address, this read access is remapped to read access to this value, the return value is 1. So first you should identify which bit you are accessing, you want to access. So this is the address, and you want to read the address, this one, so that is bit number 2. So bit number 2 of this value. So if you write 0 to this value, this write will access is remapped into read modify write, that is to this value. The value will be this, and bit 2 is cleared, and result of this will be what now? Bit 2, if it is cleared, so what will happen? C means it is what? 1100 means what? It is 8 plus 4, that will be 12, right? 10 means A, 11 means B, 12 means C. So bit 2 will be cleared, bit 0, 1, 2. So if you consider the bits here, okay, sorry. So if you consider the value C, you can write it as 1100, right? Now in this bit number 2 is what? Bit number 2 is this one. If you clear this bit, what will be the remaining value? Remaining value will be 8. So that is highlighted here. Okay, so you can check out this. So this is the example here, and here there are few advantages of the bit band operations are mentioned. So it allows, one thing is it will reduce the number of instructions to be used. So you can read the entire whole register. It allows you to mask the unwanted bits also. Even you can compare or branch the instructions also. And reading the status of a particular bit means if you want to go for a bitwise programming, so that is also allowed here. So this is the main advantage here. So I've just elaborated this advantages. You can just go through this. And another advantage is, now if you take the, go back to module 1, there we had like interrupt handler. So in case of interrupt handler, if you consider this interrupt handler, so here you can actually use this. Without bit band operation, this is not possible, because the interrupt has to halt the currently requested program, means it should allow, and currently running program should be halted. So within that time, the other program has to execute, then the main program will be allowed. But here in case of with bit band operation, what will happen? It uses a concept called as locked read modify write and locked read modify write. So this address itself in that timeline will be locked. So there is no question of interrupting, right? So it will lock that memory, and it will not allow to perform read or modify or write operation by other programs or other things, right, until the bit band operation is over. So data loss prevention is possible here. You can check out this. And similarly, the same thing here you can have. So what is given here, you can have a task, or you can divide this entire timeline as task A, B, task A, B, and task A. If there are two tasks are running, then at this timeline in the bit band, task A will be locked. So within this small amount of time, wherein the bit band region will be carried out, but you can see task B is not interrupted, so it is running as it is, so data loss will not happen here. Okay, so this is about the bit bind operation. So thank you.